Hi everyone. This tutorial explains how to solve a structure by SAD phasing using AutoSol. SAD is a widely used experimental phasing technique and stands for Single Wavelength Anomalous Diffraction. The technique consists of measuring X-ray diffraction data using energies close to the absorption edge of an anomalous scatterer. These scatterers can be purposely incorporated into the sample, such as by replacing methionine with selenomethionine, or the scatterers can be naturally present. The following inputs are needed to run AutoSol. 1. Anomalous diffraction data. This is a data file that contains separate intensities for each Fidel pair. The intensities are commonly called I+ and I-. 2. The wavelength at which the data were collected. 3. The atom type of the anomalous scatterer. And 4. The sequence of the molecule in the crystal. AutoSol will perform the following steps. First, the program locates the anomalously scattering atoms. The resulting set of coordinates is called the substructure, because it is just a part of the structure of the molecule in the crystal. Then, the substructure and the anomalous data are used to estimate crystallographic phases and calculate a density map. This initial density map can be improved with density modification. Finally, the map is interpreted by building a preliminary model that matches the map. To run this tutorial, we will use example data coming with the Phoenix installation. Open the Phoenix GUI, then click New Project and choose Setup Tutorial Data. Select the first tutorial dataset, P-Translation Initiation Factor 5A, SAD. Choose an appropriate location to save the files and click OK. To start the program, go to the right panel and click on Experimental Phasing. Then click on AutoSol and a new window opens. For bookkeeping, add a job title. To load files, click on Browse and double-click on seg.dat. The GUI now lists this file and assigned a data type to it. Seg.dat is correctly listed as a sequence file. If you want to look at the file, click on the magnifying glass. Then load the data file, p9.scar, which is in scalepack format. The GUI has correctly guessed that this is a SAD or MAD peak wavelength dataset and also assigned the correct labels. If there are several data arrays in the reflection file, it is good to double-check the data type and the labels to make sure that they are correct. To enter the wavelength, go to the box next to the Greek lambda symbol. For this experiment, the wavelength was 0.9792. To input the atom type, enter Se for selenium into the atom box. If we had measured the F prime and F double prime scattering factors, they would be entered as well. But they are not mandatory as they can be calculated from the atom type and the wavelength. We can also enter the number of NCS copies and sites if they are known. Otherwise, the program will guess them based on the volume taken up by a molecule with the provided sequence, the volume of the asymmetric unit, and the assumption that about 50% of the crystal is occupied by the molecule. Finally, check that the unit cell and the space group match those of your data collection. Then click on the Options and Output tab. Default options are typically fine, but to speed up the runtime of this tutorial, set the high resolution limit to 3 angstrom and the number of processors to 4. Then go to Run and click on Run Now to start the program. A new tab, labeled Run 1, will appear next to the Configure tab. The Status tab on the left shows what is happening now. More tabs will appear while the program is running and they will be constantly updated. Let's have a look through some of the tabs of the finished AutoSol run. The Graphs tab shows the quality of phasing as expressed by figure of merit versus resolution. The figure of merit is an estimate of phase quality, ranging from 0 to 1. It normally falls off with resolution. Acentric reflections, which have anomalous differences that yield phase information, have higher figures of merit than centric reflections, which have no anomalous differences. The Substructure Search tab shows the heavy atom sites obtained. For SAD, a figure of merit above 0.45 is very good, and between 0.25 and 0.45 is fine. The overall score is the estimated correlation coefficient between your experimental map and the true map, multiplied by 100. The higher this number is, the better the solution. Select a solution and click on Show Selected Sites, which will list below the atom type, coordinates, and occupancy for each site. The occupancies should normally all be similar, but they might not all be equal to 1 if the scattering factors are not quite right or if they are partially occupied sites. The Phasing and Density Modification tab allows visualizing the anomalous sites and density maps from this AutoSol run. Highlight the first solution and click on View Sites and Experimental Map, and then Opening Qt. A Qt window opens showing the map before density modification. Go to Edit, choose Map Parameters and set the map radius to 35 to see more of the map. Go to Draw and then go to Atom. Click Chain Z and then click on the first atom in the list to zoom in on one of the selenium sites. Now the view is centered near this atom. Notice that the map has regions that are mostly empty, the solvent, and regions that have more density, which are protein. If we zoom in, we can see some density representing protein chain, but it is not very clear. Go back to the Phasing and Density Modification tab. The lower part shows the solution from density modification. An R factor below 0.3 is ideal, but a low value does not guarantee a usable solution. Note that this is the R factor for density modification, not the crystallographic R factor for model versus data. The skew is a measure of the deviation of the distribution of electron density values in the raw phase map from a Gaussian. A skew of 0.2 is usually very good. Highlight solution 1 in the lower part. Click on View Sites and Resolve Map, and then open in Qt. The density modified map appears on top of the experimental map in the Qt window. To hide the previous map, click on Display Manager and uncheck phaser_1mtz. The density modified map is greatly improved, as the density shows connected volumes for the protein chain. The Summary tab shows final statistics and output files. The correct solution in this case is unambiguous based on visual inspection, the refinement R factors, and the correlation coefficient. To open the model and final map, click Open in Qt. Select the first atom in chain A to center on the molecule. This is a very clear map. You can get this sort of result with AutoSol if you have accurately measured high-resolution anomalous data with strong anomalous signal, as in this tutorial dataset. In more challenging cases, the map might be less clear and less model-built. Note that the final model from AutoSol is rarely complete and may contain errors. The next step is usually to run Phoenix AutoBuild, which tries to iteratively improve the map with density modification and build a more complete model. To run AutoBuild with the results of this AutoSol run, hit the Run AutoBuild button in the Summary tab. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you have any questions, contact us at help@phoenix-online.org or tutorials@phoenix-online.org.